So much young talent. Where's the young fighters? Cumel, come on. I truly believe this is going to be the next. I mean, we don't know who's going to be the next Floyd Mayweather, but I truly believe this could be the next Floyd Mayweather right here. Woo! You know, the deck can be stacked against you. As long as you believe, you're going to be okay. I needed a Floyd Mayweather in my life. I just so much for supporting me. And it's all about giving back. You know, the main thing is not just the exhibition. We came back to Miami to give back to the kids that's less fortunate. And that's what it's all about. It's about reaching out to the kids, letting them know that you someday can be the next Floyd Mayweather. You someday can be the next Mauricio Suma, or you can be Deion Taylor. You can be whatever you want to be. So if I'm able to reach out and touch and give back to the kids in the black communities and let them know that you can someday be the next Floyd Mayweather, I will always be here to do that and shine light on all the inner city kids. So many different people that's covering this event, and there's so many people out there that I want to say, there's so many people I want to say thank you to. And it's one person that I never talked about. I want them to come up. Don Hill.
That's right, Don. Over here, Don. Don.
I let Don kind of tell you guys the story because it's a real touching story.
Well, when Floyd was 16 years old, his dad had the misfortune of having to go to prison. And his dad was the stabling influence in his life at that time. He lived with his grandmother. I had a fighter named Frankie Randall that was fighting Julio Cesar Chavez out in Las Vegas. And on Monday before we fought Chavez, I went to the gym with Frankie. I was living in Grand Rapids, Michigan. And Roger Mayweather was in the gym that day. And somewhere or another, Roger found out I was from Grand Rapids. And he came over to me and said, "Look, I have a nephew that can really fight. But he's not in the gym right now. His dad went to prison. He really needs some direction. Would you be interested in trying to help him?" I said, "Sure." Have him give me a call. The next week, we met in a restaurant. The next day, Floyd moved in with us. He became family. He was someone we treated just like we treated our kids. I got him back in the gym. 6 weeks later, he won the National Golden Gloves and was fighter of the tournament. So it wasn't because of me, because I wasn't a trainer. But I was able to get some direction for Floyd that I think we had for several years. And he's still a member of our family today. I say he's the highest earning athlete in the history of the world, and I used to give him a $30 a week allowance, and he always wanted more. So, but he's somebody that my wife and my family love. And I always told Floyd, "I know you're going to be a great fighter, but it's more important to me that you're a great human being." And that's what he is.
Great day.
So that's just a part of the documentary, a part of the journey. We all got a story. We all got a story, got a story to tell. So that's a part of my documentary. That's a part of my story. And it's just that you just don't ever know who's gonna be there for you in those certain moments. You know, I've been through a lot. I've been through a lot of ups. I've been through a lot of downs. It's been a roller coaster ride. But I'm where I'm at for a reason. And even like my dad, a hell of a trainer. My dad's still behind me. And a lot of times we gotta take our hats off to the fathers. That's what we don't do. We don't take our hats off to the fathers. A lot of times we always talk about the mother, which, you know, one thing I always say, you know, we all got a job to do. And the mother, she was the nurturer. It's like for my children, the mother, she's the nurturer, and I'm the provider. And John Gotti Jr. and John Gotti III, great relationship, sort of like me and my father. We all got to start from somewhere. And I want to say thank you to Don, I want to say thank you to Dixie, Dion, and just, of course, James McNair, my right hand. Sometimes they say he's my left hand, but we work together. And just my different business partners, you know. You know, this out there, and you know, we work together on a day-to-day basis. And you know, just to be able to be in this position. Dion, I want to say bye.
I'm Ellie Seckback. Ellie Seckback reporting.
At ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.